अस्सलामुअलैकुम। RAR मल्टीबिज सर्विसेज प्राइवेट लिमिटेड इन कोलेब्रेशन विद SDU पायलट इनोवेशन आइडियाज डेवलप्ड एन एप्लीकेशन नेम्ड वन टच रेस्क्यू। दिस एप्लीकेशन इज मेनली फॉर रेस्क्यू 1122 PDM में सिविल डिफेंस एंड रिलीफ डिपार्टमेंट्स। इट इज़ गोइंग टू बी अ ब्रेक थ्रू इन इंसिडेंट रिपोर्टिंग as it will help public to report and attach pictures, audio messages and videos. Application will automatically get the location of incident and will automatically assign it to a relevant nearby officer. This will reduce the response time as the officer won't need to collect address and the reporter information. So before proceeding to any incident, rescue staff can analyze the situation by looking into the audio, video and pictorial attachments. Furthermore, reporter will have a frequent update of rescue staff coming towards him that will ease the reporter in that situation. Now coming to the screens of this application. When a user installs this application, he will be directed to this screen where he can register himself by entering his name, father name, user and selecting the nearby centers, then entering his contact number, email address and a password. Once he is registered, he can easily sign in using his username and password. After registration and coming to the sign-in screen, user needs to enter his username and a password that he entered while registration. He also needs to check the remember me sign. So in future, whenever he logs in, he don't need to enter these details. Once a user is logged in, he will be redirected to this main screen where he will be able to see different icons. Currently the selected mode is simple, whereas a user can select an advanced mode if he is capable enough to register a complaint using smart and advanced mode. Here you can see the top three icons that are namely quick help, call and report. Each of these icons have a different functionality. If a user needs just to submit a complaint using just icons and clicking them, he needs to go to quick help. There he will see all categories relevant to the incidents that can happen in daily life. Currently, the most important category is that coronavirus. So, for example, if a user needs to report a coronavirus patient, he just needs to select it and just press yes. By selecting these options, the incident report will automatically be submitted
to the authorities. And this incident report will contain information of the reporting person as well as the location. And if a person wants to talk to a representative from a certain department, he needs to click on this call icon. For example, a person needs to report a bomb blast nearby his surroundings. So he just need to click that bomb blast icon and press yes. The call number will automatically be displayed on the screen and he needs to click the call button. Similarly, if he wants to report by typing about that incident or by adding a voice message, a picture or a video of that incident, he needs to click on report. Here he needs to select the categories. For example, he wants to report a fire incident. He will have to click on fire. And here you can see he has the options to attach an image through camera or from his gallery, a video message similarly from camera and from gallery as well, or an audio message where he can record or attach an audio. He can also write the description of the incident that took place nearby him. After entering all these details, he needs to submit that incident. If a user wants to select a specific category relevant to a specific department, he just needs to select it from this drop-down. For example, if he wants to report an incident that is relevant to PDMA, he will have to click PDMA. And here the list of those incident categories will be displayed that are relevant to PDMA. After reporting and having he can enter feedback for that incident or for that whole process that took place after the reporting of this incident. These feedbacks will help our staff members to fix their issues and to process the incidents more quickly. He needs to enter his name, email address, subject, and whatever the suggestion or feedback he wants to enter, and then click submit. This application will also allow him to in finding contact information for relevant departments. For example, he needs contact number for a rescue department in Sadar. All those contact numbers relevant to rescue department are listed here. If a person wants to search for the nearest center, he just needs to click this nearest center, and by squeezing the map, he can see the pointed locations of those centers that are available. Currently, as my location is in Islamabad, so all the centers that are situated in Peshawar will be displayed here. He can select different departments from here. For example, if he clicks on PDMA and shrinks the map, he can have the location of PDMA office on the map. If a person wants to report an incident through advanced method, he just needs to click on advanced select the location by himself, and then he can report that incident in any of the categories available in this application. After all, if he needs to log out, he can simply click on the logout button and the application will log out.